So, we just checked out Naruto, which is the second film this year directed by Pablo Larraine that did Jackie. That film was amazing, so was this one. Let's talk about it. You gonna say anything or what? Let's do the review. Let's go.
Don't let your dreams be dreams.
So Naruto is about Pablo Neruda, the life of Pablo. Yeezy!
Shut the fuck up. I will fucking laser you with alien fucking eyes and explode your fucking head.
This film is about Pablo Neruda, who was basically a communist poet, politician in Chile back in the 40s, just after World War II, who went on a run because he was a communist and they were being persecuted at the time, and he is pursued by a very, very persistent detective. Now, this film is Spanish, I believe. Mm-hmm. Yep, it's the Chilean submission, or it can't be submitted for the Oscars, or it can't win the foreign language Oscar. It's been like disqualified.
I don't think it got disqualified, just didn't get selected final eight.
That's fucking criminal, because this film is amazing.
And it is thick as. I mean, considering Pablo Larraine has done two films this year, obviously he didn't make them both this year, but I mean, like, he's got two films out in 2016.
And Jackie, which was amazing!
Absolutely outstanding. And this film is just thick. There is so much to dig into here. I mean, we only just saw it a couple hours ago, but we need to sit on this one as long as we can, because it's gonna grow over time. And there is just so much to dive into here.
We know that there's more in it than we're aware of, so that's gonna kind of affect the way we review. I think we're gonna be praising like a whole lot. Like, it's so full of ideas, and it's so rich, and it has so many great parallels to so many different things, and it's got so much meaning in there that is kind of hard to take in because you're reading the subtitles, particularly in the first act. I think that was our kind of only problem with the film really overall, is that in the first act, it's so fast with dialogue that it kind of becomes difficult to absorb the images. So I will say, when you do watch this film, because you will, because it's amazing, probably watch it on a smaller screen just so you can take it all in at once with the subtitles, because those images are just glorious.
Outstanding.
The best photography of the year.
I mean, yeah, just fantastic. It's beautiful, it's jaw-dropping, it's just, it's so engaging. I mean, Pablo Larraine just captures such beautiful images, and again, with his cinematography here, he used for No in the Club, and things just, they just come to life. They're so raw, they're orgasmic. He captures the time so well. I just absolutely dig it. And the biggest thing for me here, I think, is, I mean, like, Pablo Larraine with Jackie, he used a style that was obviously very documentary, I suppose.
Yeah, documentary style,
and like, he tried to recapture history. This one, he kind of did the same thing, but all of a sudden, halfway through the film, I kind of felt as if, like, I was literally having a history book read to me, because there is, like, a narration through this, and every now and then we'd flick a page, and I'd be looking at an image, and it would stop, and on screen, these images would simply stop, and there'd be narration towards it. Like, it was such a strange experience.
You're basically seeing the story told from someone else's perspective, and it makes it really, really interesting, considering, again, this is another biopic, just like Jackie. This guy is attacking these films in a way we're not used to. Like, so many times these days we see a trailer get released for a new biopic and you go, you've seen one, you've seen them all. This is genuinely unique storytelling, and that needs to be celebrated because it's a really, really exciting thing. And for him to do two films in one year that are both at this level of quality, it's insane. I mean, the acting is fantastic, particularly from Gael Garcia Bernal, has some really, really interesting material to handle here. His character's really complex, and he absolutely nails it at every turn.
100%. All the actors across the board here have, like, really kind of strange, quite absurd sort of characters, and they really just capture them quite well to bring them to life on screen and to make it believable, because this story, as it progresses, becomes kind of less believable, but
really
also
weird.
Yeah, very believable at the same time, because it is like truth, but it's also cemented within fiction as
well. It's like a detached reality, basically. There's times where mid-conversation conversation, there'll be a dialogue scene going on, and all of a sudden it just changes location for no apparent reason until we can work out exactly why. I think it's to keep that weird, disjointed, like there's no real connect to reality, like all the characters are kind of facing within the film. I think that's a really, really smart idea.
Yeah, and I mean, like, it just takes time. I think you're just gonna really try and be patient with this film and take your time with it, because even something like the music, for example, early on I kind of found quite absurd and kind of pulled me out, but then later on I was kind of more accepting towards it because it made sense. So I think that's the biggest thing here, especially being a foreign film and speaking English as well, you really do need to take your time with this film and let it kind of like just come towards you. Don't try and rush yourself into it.
And it's a really good movie. It's essentially like an artistic chase movie, I guess. And I think like a lot of people will get a lot of enjoyment out of this one. And I think for us personally, like, we definitely really enjoyed it and we think it's really, really good, and it's great to see a director achieve his vision like this. So for me, it's a 9.3 out of 10.
And for me, it's a 9.4. Absolutely banging film. Highly recommend. Cannot wait to check it again.
So that was our review of Naruto. Have you seen it yet?
Have you seen Bailey's hair?
Fuck off.
Did you like it? Did you like the movie? Did you like this video?
Of course you did.
Well, if you crave more Bailey, check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. Oh, we've missed something!
Maybe you should subscribe before you do that. Why are you gonna do this all the time?